on this wash rack, we have a slope on either side, sloping to the center, where we have our trench that can be easily maintained by removing a bunch of metal covers that allow the debris to go inside. You will have to maintain the trench at all times when it gets full of debris. And on the very end down there is where the water is, the exit point is from this pump that pulls it out. As you can see here, we remove one of the screens, the covers, and this is where all the water exits the trench. And you'll notice a lot of debris in here. This needs to be scooped out on a daily basis. Every system will need a transfer pump to pull the water from the wash rack and put it into a holding tank. Off to the right here, we have a 150-gallon holding tank that will supply water to the rest of the system. On the left, you can see the 150-gallon tank that's going to supply water to the large clarifier. On the large clarifier, inside, under the lid, we have 10 coalescing cones helping to remove oils. We also have inside the tank a funnel that is going to skim the oils off the top. On the lower deck down there, we'll have an infeed pump that will pull water from the 150-gallon tank and put it inside the 600-gallon clarifier tank. On the control panel, we have the AMC 1000, which is our auto purge system. We also have an ozone generator. And on the far right, we have a pH control system. This is the view underneath the clarifier. On the far left, you'll see the inlet pump that brings in the water from the 150-gallon tank. In the middle, that is the AMC 1000 auto purge system. And on the right, that is our ozone pump. On the large clarifier tank, we have the clarifier piping that goes down to the clarifier holding tank. Then the water from there will be going downstream to the next system. This is our oil decanting bucket. The pipe that's coming down from the top is bringing the water and oils that are skimmed off the top from the funnel. The valve that you see there is for oil decanting. And the pipe on the left is for pulling off the waters off the bottom of the bucket and having water go back to the pit. This is our ZCF REC system. The tanks on the left have the media inside there that filter the water. The box unit on the right is our pump system and the brains with the PLC that controls all the other systems. It also has ozone built into it that allows water to be ozonated in the 500-gallon storage tank to the right. Once the water is put into the storage tank where we ozonate from time to time, this is the water that the pressure washer will be using when it is running. So it is a recycle system. In the foreground, you can see the 150-gallon infeed holding tank. And off to the right, you'll see a hot water natural gas pressure washer. Looking inside the cabinet here on the REC, we have a single pump system now. Off to the left here, we have the optional ozone tube with ozone control system. Inside the electrical box here will be a contactor for the pump and also the PLC that runs all the control systems. On this side of the wash rack, you'll notice we have four ports, four bulkheads. The bulkhead on the far, far right would be when they purge the 150-gallon tank, would be purging into this little area and go into the sludge tub. The bulkhead on the left there is for the AMC 1000, which is coming off of the 600 gallon clarifier tank. Over closer to the trough on the wash rack is another bulkhead that would be the oil decanting water that comes off the bottom of the oil decanting bucket. And then the bulkhead with the elbow pointing down, when the REC ZCF goes into backwash mode, this is where the water would exit. Over here on the right, you'll see the sludge tub, and we will show you the inside pieces. So now we're looking inside the sludge tub. Now this unit is not fully plumbed up yet, but when it is, the water will enter from the left-hand side and go into a hose barb nipple that will collapse around or wrap around the burlap bag. The burlap bag is raised up in the air on a stainless steel table, which will keep it off of the floor, and then the bucket will be plumbed in such a way that it will dewater itself off the bottom.